How's it going, everybody? It's Sean here, and I'm back today to give you guys a review of this Nike SB Dunk Low Pro Premium from the Dictionary of Color Combinations pack in this orange and noise aqua colorway. So this shoe is part of a two-shoe Nike SB Dunk Low pack, which are inspired by a Dictionary of Color Combinations. This is a classic book written in the 1930s by Sanzo Wada, and this book is all about color theory, color research, and color combinations. So these two dunks are specifically inspired by actual color combinations within that book. So these released back in July for a price of $110 US or $145 here in Canada. And the official colorway for this shoe is orange, noise aqua, and emerald rise. So taking a look at the details, just like the other pair, the Mystic Red colorway, the upper of the sneaker is constructed out of this vintage looking long haired distressed suede. So on the toe box, you can see the suede here. This is done in this faded mint color. And just like any other dunk, we have these perforations found all across. Surrounding the front toe cap, we have this very aged looking orange suede, and this covers the eyelets of the sneaker as well. Underneath this on the mid panel, we have more of that teal colored suede. And then stitched on top of this, we have a suede swoosh. And this time it's done in a blue shade instead. Moving downwards, covering the side flaps of the shoe, we have more of that orange colored suede, and this covers the bottom of the heel as well. And then above this, we have more of that mint colored suede, and then the top of the heel, this is covered in another hit of orange suede, but we have Nike branding embroidered across in blue. In terms of laces, so these come with two different lace options. The one that the shoe comes with is an oval shaped lace in orange with these blue colored lace tips, but if you're not feeling the contrast, they also give you a secondary pair of tonal mint colored laces as well. Underneath this, the tongue is constructed just like most Nike SB Dunks, so we have a padded tongue, and this time it's covered in this mint colored nylon material, and then on the very top of the tongue we have this orange colored tag with Nike SB branding woven across in blue. On the back of the tongue, you can see we have this number here, 181. So this isn't referencing how limited this shoe is. This is the actual color combination number that's found within that book. And then you'll see that the back of the tongue and the interior of the shoe, this is covered in this teal or mint colored mesh. And being a Nike SB Dunk Low Pro silhouette, we have these additional pillows of cushioning on the back of the shoe. And this gives you more cushioning and more impact protection. And it gives the shoe more of a snug fit as well. Moving on to the insoles, so these come with a foam lined insole. However, the top is covered in a tonal teal or mint color. And then pressed onto the heel, we have Nike SB and Air Zoom branding. And this being a Nike SB Dunk, of course, we have that Zoom Air unit that's attached to the bottom of the insole, which is there to help with impact protection and shock absorption when you land on your heels. So the upper of these dunks sits atop this solid rubber cup sole, which is painted in this very yellow vintage looking finish. If you look real close, just like the Mystic Red colorway, there's a bunch of speckling found throughout, so I can't confirm or deny if this is true, but this might mean that they utilized recycled rubber on this shoe, which if true would be a nice thing to see. And then finally, turning this pair over to the bottom, so this outsole is constructed out of a tonal rubber in the same yellowed colored finish. This being a Nike SB Dunk Low Pro, once again, we have more of an aggressive traction pattern. So we have this circular traction pattern on the forefoot, which loops around the circular pivot point. And then right in the middle, we have this exposed wedge of foam with Nike SB branding. So that breaks down the look and the construction of these dunks. And for those wondering about sizing, to me, these fit like most of my other Nike SB dunks. So my foot measures as a true size 10, slightly on the wider side. And for SB Dunk Lows, I usually go up to a 10.5, which is a half size up. So if you have a narrow or normal width foot, I feel like true to size should be fine for you. But for those watching who have a bit more of a wider foot, and if you have a really wide foot, I would definitely recommend going up that half size. Because SB Dunks are more padded than a typical Nike sportswear dunk, it just feels more constricting all around, especially around this toe box area, where I can usually feel pressure on my foot right where my toes start, as well as around the pinky toe area. But whatever size you normally go with, just stick with that exact same size, and you should be okay for this pair. Moving on to the comfort, so these feel like any other Nike SB Dunk Low. So unfortunately, to me at least, it's really not a comfortable sneaker. This is technically meant to be skateboarded in, so it has performance in mind, meaning it's going to be very supportive, flat, low to the ground, and stable as well. What you're not going to get is a lot of cushioning underfoot, so it doesn't have that pillowy feel whatsoever. So I guess in the grand scheme of things, for just an everyday casual use shoe, they're going to be fine, but it's just not a model that I would wear if I know I'm going to be on my feet for hours and hours on end, and it's not a shoe that I would bring with me on vacation either. Finally, in terms of the quality and the craftsmanship on this shoe, so first off, material quality, just like the Mystic Red pair, I was a big fan of the suede that they used. this long-haired, vintage-looking, distressed shaggy suede. I love the look of this shoe, and for some reason it reminds me of like my elementary school days with this unique color combination. But from a build and craftsmanship standpoint, I'm pretty sure I just got a bad pair, but I had a ton of glue stains on the upper of the shoe. When I compared this one to the Mystic Red, this one was noticeably worse. So hopefully your pairs weren't full of glue stains, but I'm betting that it was just my pair. Aside from that though, the shoe was pretty well built. The stitch job was good, the panels were cut in place consistently, so it was a bit of a bummer that I got a pair with a ton of glue stains. But other than that, I really had no major complaints. So with all that out of the way now, let me toss these on feet, I'll lace them up for you, and I'll show you guys how these look. Between this one and the Mystic Red, while the Mystic Red might be the more wearable pair, it's a bit more subdued. For some reason, I'm just really feeling this wild and crazy color combination that this shoe has. Yes, it's not going to be the easiest shoe to pull off, it's extremely loud, but I think if you rock these with a bit more of a muted outfit and let the shoes be the star of the show and let it shine, I think this is a really solid shoe to wear in the summer. And kind of like I mentioned earlier, it just reminds me of days gone by. It has this really retro feel to it. Maybe it's because of this vintage distressed looking suede, but this color palette to me has a really strong 1970s vibe to it. So let me know in the comment section down below, what do you guys think about these A Dictionary of Color Combinations Nike SB Dunks? What are your thoughts on this specific colorway? And between this one and the Mystic Red, which of the two do you guys prefer? If you guys like this video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. You can follow me on my Instagram account at sgo8, check out my Twitter page at sean.go, and visit my website at seangoe.ca. So thanks so much for watching, hopefully you guys enjoy this review, and I'll catch you guys all in the next one.